KTLA proudly celebrates Black History Month with visionaries in Southern California, but our next guest traveled to us from the city of Houston, Texas.
That's right. Michael Taylor is a motivational speaker and CEO of a publishing company. He's also the author of a new book titled Shattering Black Male Stereotypes, Eradicating the 10 Most Destructive Media Illusions About Black Men. Good to see you. Thanks for flying all the way here to see us. Okay, so let's talk about your personal story. It's about overcoming adversity, but not one big victory. You've had some failures that led you to this day.
Well, if we go back about 25 years, I was living the American dream. I had the house, the wife, the 2.5 kids, and all of that. Then I went through a divorce, a bankruptcy, a foreclosure, a deep state of depression. I was homeless for 2 years living out of a car. And then I simply made a commitment that I was gonna transform my life. And I went on this amazing journey of transformation. Started reading books, going to seminars, and was able to put my life back together. And then I decided, you know what? I need to share the lessons that I learned through this process with others to support them in overcoming adversity in their lives.
So 2 years in a homeless, that's a big deal.
Yes, 2 years.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, you dress pretty nice now, I'll say that. All right, so let's look at the your first stereotype, which they said black men are an endangered species. That's also a famous line from Chris Rock monologue.
Yeah, well, let's go back a little bit, because I personally believe that all black men are positioned to experience unprecedented levels of success in society today. I don't buy into all the negative media stereotypes, but the reason it's so important to recognize them, I can go back to a situation where I was in a restaurant once, and these two men were having a conversation about the eradication of black men from society. Mm-hmm. And I walked over to their table and I asked the guy, I said, man, please tell me you don't believe what you just said. And the guy looked at me and he said, absolutely. He says, don't you watch the news? He said, I believe in 20 years, all black men are going to be dead or in jail. And it literally broke my heart.
Was this two African-American men?
Yes, two young black males. And I said, you know, I knew there was nothing I could say that would change their mind. So I put my hand on his shoulder and I said, don't believe the hype. But I knew that I needed to do something. And that's when I started writing, because I wanted to change the mindset of black men. And I started writing books back in 1995 as a result of that conversation.
What can the media do to change that?
Well, first of all, they need to have conversations like this.
Yeah.
And expose more positive stories about what we're doing in society. Mm-hmm. Because there are a lot of success stories out there that you don't see. Lots of programs out there that are empowering men of color. And so we need to see more of that, more positive news.
Another stereotype that all black men are deadbeat dads.
Yeah, and here's one we can refute pretty easily. There's a guy in Australia named Steve Bidoff, and he did a study. And what he found was he came up with what's called the 30-30-30-10 rule. And what he said, if you put 100 men in a room, regardless of race, regardless of religion, regardless of socioeconomic status, 30% of those men would have absolutely no relationship with their father. 30% of those men would have what he calls an estranged relationship with their father. Mm-hmm. 30% of those men would have what he calls a holiday relationship with their father, meaning they're in the child's life, but they only really connect on holidays. And then he said only 10% would have what he calls an emotionally, spiritually, psychologically healthy relationship with their father. So it's not a racial issue when it comes to fatherhood, it's a masculine issue. And how do we teach men to become better fathers? And that's one of the things that I really focus on.
And what do you tell people in your book about that topic?
Well, I break down, first of all, the importance to understand that being a great father is not genetic. It's a learned behavior.
Oh, yeah.
Any man can learn to become a great father. I didn't have a great relationship with my dad, but I went to seminars, I read books, I had mentors, I became a great father. And I can say that without question, I am very proud, because it's one of my greatest accomplishments, being a great dad.
Another myth you talk about is the portrayal of black men, which kind of fits in with the deadbeat dads, is they're not monogamous.
Monogamous, absolutely. And this goes back, if you go back to the 70s, when the black exploitation films came out, black men were seen as pimps and hustlers. And then you move into the 90s, and rap music becomes prevalent, and we hear this thing about being a player. And so that's something that's been perpetuated for a long time. But what you seldom see in the media are black men who are in loving, intimate, tender, nurturing relationships. You very seldom see that in the media.
And then, of course, this media hype that we had, of course, over Colin Kaepernick, he was making a stand. This brought a lot of emotions on both sides here. But it also showed that possibly maybe black men are not patriotic.
Sure. And I think Stephen Covey said it best when he said, seek first to understand and then be understood. And so I can understand how some people could be upset when it appears that he's disrespecting the flag in the military. But we have to understand that because we protest doesn't mean we don't love this country. As a matter of fact, I'll say just the opposite. We're protesting because we love this country and want to make sure that this country lives up to its ideals. And so I personally can speak for myself. I absolutely love America. I love everything about this country. And I think the majority of black men feel the same way.
All right, again, Michael Taylor is a motivational speaker. He's a coach, also an author. And for more about him and his book, you can go to his website and follow him on Instagram. Again, the book, Shattering Black Male Stereotypes.
We'll be right back.